cover this very transparent blue layer.
When we started the treatment of the Pellegrini paintings, we thought that it would be more or less just a straightforward treatment, varnish and overpaint removal, and re-varnishing and in-painting. But when we removed a very yellow discolored varnish, the paintings had a dull gray appearance and the bright Rococo palette was just not realized. So through this collaboration with Shell, we were actually able to do analysis of the paint, and we realized that there's actually another layer on top of the paint that is composed of inorganic salts that is giving the paintings this dull gray appearance.
De volgende stap is natuurlijk, van, nou ja, okay, we hebben vastgesteld wat het is, die grauwsluier op het schilderij. Is het mogelijk om die weer te verwijderen zonder de originele verf die eronder zit te beschadigen? Pellegrini staat juist bekend om het gebruik van zijn heldere kleuren. En die grauwsluier die maken die schilderij gewoon heel erg somber. Dus het was in ieder geval erg gewenst om iets te vinden daarop. En met een klein team, mensen van het Mauritshuis en Universiteit van Amsterdam, hebben we een hele reeks oplosmiddelen gels gemaakt op maat. En we hebben ook proefplankjes gemaakt waarop we dan die zoutuitbloei gingen imiteren. En daar hebben we eerst die gels op losgelaten en getest voordat we ze op de schilderij zelf gingen testen.
So after we had ascertained the types of salts in the crust, we prepared test panels with aged paint and applied the three main salts separately to these test panels. So when we were testing the gels, we really concentrated on their effectiveness for the removal of the salt, the amount of time that was required, the amount of mechanical action required to remove the salt, and the amount of residue left as well after cleaning. And based on the results that we got from testing the gels on the panels, we were able to select about 5 to 6 gels to actually test on the paintings themselves. And we're now making a plan for removing the crusts from the surface of the paintings.